Hey guys, happy December! I cannot believe we are at the end of 2015 and we have already are into December. It literally just blows my mind. A year ago today, well not today, but a year ago this month is when I promoted to Diamond. And wow, like things completely changed. And there's a few things I have on my mind that I want to talk to you guys about. And I'll try not to ramble too much, but you know how I get. First of all, what do we do at the first of the month? We print out those steps to success. And you guys hear me talk about those steps all the time. I don't talk about it just because, you know, I like to talk about them. I talk about them because they work. They really work. And I got goosebumps today when I saw the our newest Black Diamonds talking about the steps that they work to get there. Guys, we get those same steps. I can do the same thing by working those steps. The only difference is they've done way more steps than I have. That's the only difference. And I need you guys to see that. You have your hands on a tool that can make you over $100,000 a month. You just have to work those steps. And so I've been thinking like, just like throughout my journey and stuff, of a couple of things that I feel like were really kind of game-changing moments. And I want to share them with you guys. And I have a challenge for you this month. So my challenge is, this month, I don't want you to say you're going to create a 1% change. I don't want you to say you're going to step out of your comfort zone. I want you to do it. We are all guilty for saying, I'm going to create a 1% change and this is what it is. One of my 1% changes was that I was going to wake up at 5:30 in the morning every day. I haven't done that. I stay up way too late. I just, you know, there's no way I get up at 5:30 in the morning every morning. I just haven't done it. That's one of my things that I said I was going to do and I just have not committed to it. And we're all guilty of those things. But there was a video I watched by Lydia Diaz a couple of months ago that I cannot get it out of my mind. And in the video, she talks about how God created us for greatness and how it's so easy to just get stuck in that rut that, oh, well, I'm not very good at, you know, sticking to a schedule, so screw it, I'm not going to do schedules. Or, oh, I'm not very good at posting on Facebook, so I'm just not going to post at Facebook. That's not for me. Or, I'm not very good at blitzing, so I just won't blitz. Guys, that's the devil. That is the devil telling you that you can't do those things. God did not create you like that. God created you to tackle anything you can do. You can do anything. Are you telling me that you can't do something? You've got God's help. No way. There's nothing on the face of this earth that you cannot do, that you cannot accomplish if you apply yourself. So it made me start thinking of some things that I am so guilty of saying, like, oh my gosh, example. I am not good at Instagram. I don't understand it. It doesn't make sense to me. It's out of my comfort zone. I can't do Instagram. That's been my motto, like, or my saying for several months. As much as I know that I needed to get into it, I just kept saying that. And literally, when I saw that video, that's the first thing that popped in my mind. In the last couple months, God has been like, Jacqueline, why? Why are you allowing the devil to convince you that you cannot figure out Instagram? Why can you not figure out Instagram? So this past month, in November, I tackled Instagram with a vengeance. I literally went out building relationships, meeting new people, trying to find a way that I can just reach out to people, share this adventure, share this journey. It was amazing. I stepped out of my comfort zone. I created a 1% change. I didn't step into it. I kind of like jumped and ran into it. I went all in and it was amazing. I have met three new business partners through Instagram this month that are complete sweethearts that I absolutely am so excited to take this new journey with. And if I would not have made that uncomfortable step, they would not be on our team right now. And it was because God literally said, stop with the excuses and get on it. I've always been one that says, just run with it. Who cares? Fake it till you make it. You know, make mistakes along the way. Like, that's my motto. But for some reason, I could not have that motto with Instagram. And I finally just said, who cares? You don't know how Instagram works. That's fine. You're going to make mistakes. That's fine. Just do it. And don't just do it. Like, do it all in. And I think about another time where, you know, I needed something to change. And it was blitzing. I was, you know, I didn't really blitz. I kind of was nervous about it and scared about it. And one week I just made myself go all in crazy. And here's the thing, guys, when you really take a hold of that change and you jump in and you go crazy, you're going to find that it becomes easier and that you actually start to like it. I enjoy blitzing. I am actually liking Instagram. I'm starting to figure it out. It's fun. I'm meeting new people. I'm enjoying it. But there's also a thing too, that once you figure it out, once you go all in, now like this month, I can't just like step back. I got to go more. I got to figure out more about Instagram. I got to, you know, I got to do more blitzing and sharing this opportunity with people. You've always got to want that desire for more. Remember, God's created us for greatness. We can always do more. But this goes for our personal life as well. You know, you might be thinking, gosh, I really need to get into the gym. I challenge you, get to the gym this month. Make it a commitment, don't give in, and go. But then, of course, you've got that next month. You do really good this month. Next month, it's going to be cold. You don't want to go to the gym. You've got to pull yourself out of that and say, no, I've made this change. It feels good. It's created a change in my life. I'm going to stick with it. So sticking with it is just as hard as creating the change. But you guys just got to, you've got to do it. It's all about discipline. You know, you need to be disciplined to do it. And it's so easy to talk the talk, but it's time to walk the walk. You guys know something that you can change. So right now I'm challenging you to think, God created me for greatness. What excuse am I allowing to get in my personal life? What excuse am I allowing to get in the way of my faith? What excuse am I allowing to get in the way of my business? We all make them. And that's just the devil keeping you from moving on and helping others. You've got to end it. You've got to say today, December 1st, this is my month. I'm ending it. I'm challenging myself to be greater, to do greatness, and this is what I'm changing. And I challenge you guys to go all in. It feels amazing. I just love when I have these like moments because it really does change. Things changed for me last month, and it feels amazing. I needed that change. Guys, I get blows thrown to me just as you guys, you know, someone quits on your team, you lose loyal customers. It happens to me too. But that person that quits is not in control of my business. It's me. I'm in control of my destiny. I'm in control of making my dreams come true, not the person that quit. You cannot rely on those people. You cannot let them bring you down. This is your business. You make that commitment today that you're going to do anything and everything for your why, for you, for your business. And it doesn't matter what happens. You keep trucking. You put those blinders on and you keep going because we all know what is going to take us to the top. Steps to success. You can do it. You have the steps. You can do it. So, all right, it's already been, it's been 10 minutes. Okay, so I want to end the call with something else. All right, when I joined, I did not even realize that I did not know what hope felt like. And I realized it when I found it. And I was like, wow, Jacqueline, this is hope. This is what hope feels like. Let me tell you guys, I didn't have that feeling when I went diamond. I had that feeling a month or two when I started the business. My paychecks weren't big. My business was just starting. I was just starting to figure it out. I didn't know nothing yet. But what I got was hope. And how I got that was a vision. The vision of what It Works was bringing to my family. The vision that this is a Christian company blessed by God. Anything that God has His hands on provides us hope. And I saw that no matter what comes in my way, this company was providing me with something that was priceless and felt amazing, and I had not had it for as long as I can remember. And that was feeling of hope, that no matter what happened, if I just kept my blinders on and kept going, that things were going to happen for me, things were going to happen for my family, that I was going to be able to provide the same thing for my friends and my family and strangers that came on board with this business. The feeling of hope. Do you have that feeling right now? If you don't, I don't want you to look at your paycheck. Paycheck does not determine hope. I want you to look at this business. Do you see the vision? Do you see what this company gives us? These products that people want. Do you see the vision of what can happen if you keep your head down and you keep going? I challenge you to look for that. If you don't have that, I hope that you can find that this month. Because this company provides hope for free. And it's not based on your paycheck. It's based on what you see. And I want you guys to see that anything is possible as long as you apply yourself and go after it. Take those excuses out the window. Nothing's going to happen with excuses. It's just going to keep you buried in the sand. No excuses this month. Out the window, see the vision because you have hope. It comes with the vision. It doesn't come with the paycheck. So this month, I want you guys to find your hope and believe that it's possible. Anything is possible. It doesn't matter where you live. It doesn't matter, you know, if you work full time or if you're a student or if you're a mom or if you are going crazy. I'm going crazy. It doesn't matter, guys. Hope is there for you to grab. Grab it. Step out of your comfort zone. Go all in. 1% change, guys. Find that what you need to do this month and change it. And enjoy the moment because things will change for you this month. And then next month, let's do it again. Let's do it better and keep improving and keep finding that 1% change. So I love you guys. I just know that amazing things are going to happen for all of you. It literally just boils down to holding on to that hope and holding on to the fact that you have the tools. So you just have to go do it. So let's do it. December to Remember is an epic month. Let's finish 2015 strong because 2016 is going to be amazing. And I am so excited for you all. So love you guys. Have a great, great, great month.